Last summer, when Israeli citizens were facing a barrage of rockets fired by extremists located principally in Gaza, that there was a significant infusion of American resources into the Iron Dome program there. The president received a request from the Israeli government to help them replenish their stockpile of Iron Dome rockets. The president worked closely with the Congress to expedite that request. And that is an indication that this president is willing and has demonstrated a willingness to act decisively to protect the national security of our allies in Israel. Now, the president does that because he believes it's in the national security interest of the United States for us to continue to have a strong relationship with our allies in Israel. And the president is determined to make sure that party politics don't somehow trump how critically important this relationship is, that that for generations, American and Israeli political leaders have succeeded in putting aside their partisan affiliation to focus on the best interests and the best national security interests of the citizens of their country. And that is why the president has said that he's not going to meet with the prime minister when he's in Washington in early March. His visit comes just a couple of weeks before the prime minister is on the ballot, and the president does not want to be in a position of even appearing to interfere with the outcome of an Israeli election.
Today, Netanyahu tweeted, and in English, which isn't typical for him in time for morning East Coast consumption, "I'm determined to speak before Congress to stop Iran." Do you consider that a response to what the president said yesterday? And is there a back and forth going on between the president and Bibi Netanyahu?
If there is, I'm certainly not going to continue it from here.